I'm Miguel. Welcome. We are celebrating Dia de los Muertos, the Day of the Dead. And this is my family's ofrenda, where we put photos of our loved ones from the past.
Miguel, come help me with dinner.
I'll be right back. Come in, Mama.
Greetings. Welcome to the land of the dead. Don't you worry. Your time in the land of the living is not yet over. However, you are expected on stage at the Plaza de la Cruz. So choose a look that suits you and be on your way. Enjoy.
Huh? Bienvenidos. Welcome to the Studio de Arte. Please feel free to explore and enjoy the many works of art celebrating our exciting and vibrant Land of the Dead. To begin your tour, please step ahead and enter the gallery to your left. You have entered the exhibit of José Guadalupe Posada, considered by many to be the father of Mexican modern art. He inspired many famous artists throughout the world. Born in 1852 in the town of Aguascalientes, Mexico, José Posada began his artistic career in his early teens, learning printmaking and engraving. By the time he was 19, Posada was the head cartoonist for the paper El Jicote, The Wasp. Coincidentally, my uncle Fernando entered the Land of the Dead after being stung by an Aguascalientes wasp. I come from a proud family with a long history of anaphylactic shock. This is Posada's La Catrina. It is perhaps the most famous example of the calaveras tradition, in which Posada used skulls and skeletons to comment on all aspects of society and occupations.
Harder. Harder. Too hard! Really?
Lining the hallway, you'll find skull illusion landscapes by Sonia Sarskin. There's a quiet interior scene with a skull window and a painting of the giant tule tree with a skull hidden in its branches. This painting shows a skull at the end of a typical looking alleyway here in the Land of the Dead. The artist cleverly uses papel picado banners for the skull's eyes. Is it just me, or do they seem to follow you around the room? If you look back toward the entrance, you can see another skull illusion suspended from the ceiling. Now we have a special treat for you. As you already know, here in the Land of the Dead, we love our sugar skull motifs. It's a tradition to paint our own faces with colorful patterns and designs. If you like, you can decorate your face. To get started, pop your head off and place it on the table. Once your head is on the table, feel free to paint it however you please. Don't forget to grab your head when you're done. Seriously. You don't want to be stuck staring at the inside of the lost and found box. inspired by the city of Guanajuato, Mexico, there are two beautiful paintings by Shelley Wan. The first is the cityscape of the Land of the Dead with its multicolored buildings. The other is of the Marigold Bridge on the eve of Dia de Muertos. The brightly lit marigold petals are in stark contrast to the muted background which is shrouded in the evening's heavy atmosphere. This is an illustration by Harley Jessup of our Department of Family Reunions. Here, questions regarding ofrenda photos and other family issues are handled and recorded. Bureaucratically, it's very similar to the Department of Motor Vehicles in the Land of the Living. We also have a Department of Motor Vehicles which my Aunt Gloria refers to as the Third Death. Because if being forgotten doesn't get you, waiting there for a license renewal will. This cityscape is by Daisuke Tatsumi. The painting is adorned with his skeletal images and captures the verticality of the Land of the Dead. You might notice that many of the towers and buildings are connected by bridges that are precarious at best. You see, in a place where you can't hurt yourself, the local municipality doesn't really focus on safety issues. Here is a fanciful bust of the monstrously funny film director Pedro Doctor. To the right, you'll find a sculpture of the alebrije, or spirit animal, Pepita, by Greg Dykstra. Thank you.
Okay, now you. Come on, yell. Give me your best grito.
Come on.
Échale,
gana. Ah, you're funny. Come on. Un, dos, tres.
Hey, let's go, Ándale, vamos. Emma, hey. Show me what you got.
Vamos.
Hey, buenísimo.
Ándale, you can do it.
Muy bien.
Baila, amigo.
Are you okay? You look like you were daydreaming. Anyway, did I ever tell you the story of my mama Imelda? She was my great-great-grandma and the first shoemaker in our family. Oh, did I mention my whole family makes shoes? There's a long history of the Riveras making shoes.